Trigger inputs may be used to activate recording or other events on the ExacqVision system. The opposite of this are alarm outputs, which allow a signal from the system to activate external actions. On hybrid systems or IP-only systems with a USB DIO module attached, there are two trigger input pages and two alarm output pages. The first set is nested beneath the Add IP Cameras and Camera Recording nodes in the configuration tree to the left. These pages allow changes to be made to trigger or alarm settings for the connected IP devices. The second set is nested beneath the Exact Input Output module. This page configures triggers or alarms connected directly to the input-output board installed in the system. These pages are configured in the same way, the primary difference being that the system's trigger input and alarm output pages do not display device details, such as the IP addresses of devices. If you have a hybrid system with an Exact USB DIO attached as well, you will see more than one Exact input-output module nodes in the tree. The Trigger Inputs page displays a list of the inputs, the normal state, as well as the current status. For easier identification, users may opt to give the inputs unique names. Trigger inputs are used to receive a digital TTL signal from external sources. These may then be tied to events within ExacqVision to perform actions such as recording video or audio, or sending notifications. Configuring these actions will be covered in more detail in the event linking video. The configuration of these inputs allows a user to select the normal state of the input, either open or closed. To detect an event that triggers when a nominal voltage is present on the inputs, set the normal state to open. This will tell the system that this particular input is in an alarm status when a voltage is detected. If a voltage is usually present and you wish to detect a break in that current, set the normal state to closed. Voltages between 0 volts and 0.8 volts will be detected as open or low. Voltages must be between 2.0 volts and 5 volts to be detected as closed or high. The Alarm Outputs page displays a list of the outputs. These may also be renamed for easier identification. The Relay column will indicate if the alarm output is a relay or not. A relay is an unpowered switch that merely breaks a point in the circuit and closes it when activated. This means that the current connected to it must be powered. When in an alarm state, the relay closes and completes the circuit, passing the current to the device connected. The maximum power applied should not exceed 24 volts DC and 1 amp max. For non-relay alarm outputs, you should not apply external power. These are powered TTL circuits providing 5 volts at no more than 50 milliamps of current, intended to be connected to the input of external devices. They may also be used to trigger user-provided external relays capable of controlling much greater current. A knowledge base article detailing control of both AC and DC currents using alarm outputs can be found on the Exact Support portal. By changing the normal state field, users can determine what the non-alarm state of the output will be. High outputs 5 volts, while low outputs 0 volts. Setting the normal state to low means that the majority of the time 0 volts are applied, but when alarmed, a 5 volt current is applied. Setting the normal state to high reverses this and applies 5 volts most of the time, but cuts the current when in an alarm status.